Good day! Look at that sun! I'm wearing the Kevlar jeans, and more importantly, I'm wearing knee sliders. So I took the original knee protectors out. I'm trying this system out. And there's a knee slider up high side, which at first I was really doubtful about, because I looked into these things earlier. A lot of people are positive about them, and a lot of people say, well, yeah, it works. So I decided to buy one and try it. So I did film the unboxing, so you get a better view on how they look and about the quality. And so far, the first couple of minutes when they are put on, it's kind of a little bit annoying inside the inside of your knee. But when you're using them and you have been riding a little bit, that annoyance goes away quite quickly. And at some point it's just, yeah, they're comfortable. Well, not really comfortable, but doable, not annoying in any way. Now, obviously, this is the first time I'm wearing them, so they're still untouched perfect. But if I'm gonna do the track day, I did want knee sliders for myself, just in case. Now I have the... What the hell? There's pink smoke. Oh, there are torches. Okay. Interesting. I mean, the corner is amazing, but there are too many cars there to really push it a lot of times. And when you can actually push it, it takes quite a lot of time before you're there again, mainly due to the traffic light there. So it's not a corner you can repeat. So that's one of the reasons why I want to do the track day, so I can repeat and see if I can push myself to improve. My aim is not to ever get these knee sliders on the ground. I am not aiming for that, but I'm just want to push myself to improve. And if I can push myself to improve and it happens that my knee sliders are there, that means that they are there to protect my knees. So I want them to be there just in case. Just in case. I mean, I know in theory, it is possible to get your knees on the ground on this bike. I don't think I have the capabilities, but that's what you do practice when you're going on a circuit day or a track day like that. You are practicing to improve your skill, keep pushing it until the point that it might happen. Like I said, I'm not aiming for it to happen, but if it happens, I want the protection there. I don't want to ruin either textile jeans or my Kevlar jeans. That would be a shame. Let alone if I would ruin my skin. Because if you get to that point, you by the sheer pain, I imagine that you do something, break or pull gas, and your bike goes. So protection, that's the main part. Even if they stay perfectly in one piece, perfectly untouched for the upcoming years, I don't care. So yeah, by the time that you will see this video, I will already have uploaded it, but I'm editing a Dutch vlog, which is a two-way vlog between me and Moto Test TV. And it's really interesting because partly there were some audio troubles, which make it a little bit harder to edit, and partly because my voice is a little bit different in Dutch, and it's really, really awkward to hear myself talking Dutch. I am used to myself talking English now, so now I need to get used to myself talking Dutch, which will not happen often, but from time to time stuff will be done in Dutch. And I can easily make the jump to Dutch, but I still have so many UK people and people from India, and the best videos that I've uploaded are me helping a cager out that's stuck. So pushing a car, and then I think I have 9 reviews before the first vlog. and reviews are popular, especially outside Netherlands. I could always say, well, I'm doing everything in Dutch except the reviews, but it's either one way or the other, man. And again, I'm doing a test a mic video, a vlog, a replacement of the mic, testing a mic video, a vlog. That's the point that I uploaded the first testing the mic. So this is the third testing mic, third vlog after that. And the second mic testing I've not really listened to at all, or edited at all. I'm a little bit behind on the upload schedule because I had a little bit time to upload other stuff. Like upcoming weekend will be hopefully the last bit of the manifesto ride. It's funny because yesterday I uploaded the I Am Blue video, which has nothing to do with that literally song, other than me singing da ba dee da ba dee, that's part. And it was a really thinking point for me from should I put it in or should I edit it out. And I decided, you know what, I'm gonna sing in so much stuff the upcoming videos, and I can cut everything every time out, but this one was just, I don't know, a little bit better, so I decided to leave it in. And the first response that I got was the full song text to that song. Now, knowing the person, there's a very realistic option that he knew the entire song text by mind. However, I don't think he typed it out because there were no spelling errors. So even if he did know the full lyrics by head, and that could be very, 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 very possible, he did not type them out. Because if he would have typed them out, there were spelling errors. At least one or two. There are the calves. I mean, Scottish Highlanders are a beautiful breed of cow. I did work at a petting zoo and we didn't have those cows, sadly enough. We had other beautiful cows, of course, but that's a different story. How does your mind go? So yeah, center. We were talking about blue. Blue's clues. So yeah, he did copy it, the text. It has to be. But still, for me it was perfect that was the first comment. So I had to pin it as well. It's one of those videos that actually gets more comments than anticipated, but like every other Thursday video, isn't that high in views. The Sunday videos do higher in views, even sometimes they are worse, they do better in views, because probably my guess would be that people in the weekend have more time to watch stupid guys on motorcycles vlog, so that is why the Sunday vlog does better. And well, the 1,000 subscribers is slowly creeping closer and closer. Those other margin yet hit the 4,000 viewing hours. Yeah, that will take quite some time before I reach that. Quite some time. That isn't the main target. The 1,000 subscribers would be amazing. That would really be like a celebration to like 7 years or something on YouTube. A lot of times on the stuff there where you can share your videos, like motorvlog.com or motorforum, whatever, stuff like that. I'm there active and then I'm period not active and then I'm period active and then I'm period not active. And I don't know why. Me being active in public time, it gets me bored, so I have to leave it for a little bit and I come back again. And I don't think there's a real problem, but it does mean that certain videos are not getting pumped out in all those places, and some do. And if you're always constantly pumped out in all those places, you do get easier recognized, and maybe that would help with some extra subscribers, but yeah. I mean, I do consider myself loyal to, for example, motorvlog.com. Every time I mention them, I will put a link in the description box. I'm sharing and being active there for, I don't know, however long ago. I want to say 3 years, but I'm not quite sure. It could be 2 years, it could even be 4 years. I'm not quite sure. I've been on there quite some time already. And it's a fun little motovlog website to just browse through from time to time. I think the main person I'm following on YouTube that I met on motovlog.com is Hippodrones. I think I met XT Donkey there, which got my attention because he drove an XT. Although I think he sold it by now. Something like that was on the Twitters. But I do think I'm gonna end it here. More than enough rambling on. And thinking of titles of these weird stuff, these weird commute vlogs, is even more difficult. Sometimes I just should ramble on and just delete the footage directly. And only keep whatever is seems to be on subject. Thank you for watching. Peace out. Till the next time. Bad to the bone.